Marc. So nice to see you.
Nice to see you.
Marc entered Britain's Got Talent in 2018.
It was the most incredible experience of my life.
My name is Marc Spelmann, and I was a semi-finalist on Britain's Got Talent.
Are you a magician?
I am indeed.
The first audition was amazing.
This app is going to change your life.
To get the golden buzzer was incredible. I had a lot of people telling me that I could win.
The act going through to the final is Griffith Win.
But it's like, and I was out. I was so disappointed. And I remember thinking, you know, that can't be it. There has to be a way. And that was the birth of X. I came back again as an anonymous character who didn't look like me, didn't sound like me.
I am X.
I have no idea who you are, but what you do is unbelievable.
I made it to the final. And when the mask came off, the emotion was overwhelming.
I am absolutely dumbfounded.
But I still didn't win.
Colin Thackeray!
I was runner-up, and now we're here at the Champions.
Okay, here we go.
This is my chance to finally do it.
Since Britain's Got Talent, X has become so much more than just me. We can all be X if we want to be.
Good evening.
Good evening.
It is an honor to be here in this great nation. You have all seen so many wonderful acts throughout your time. I am sure there are certain acts that stand out for each of you. On the other side of these cards are some of the most memorable people related to Got Talent around the world. Simon, you can see there are 10 different colors. Please tell me which one you would like.
I'll go for yellow, please.
Heidi, can you tell me which symbol you would like?
The smiley face.
Alicia, please choose any letter.
S.
And finally, Howie, choose any number here.
Unlucky 13.
A moment I didn't foresee. Simon, your colour.
Huh?
Heidi, your symbol.
Symbol.
And Alicia, your letter. Were always going to be yours. Howie will get back to yours in a moment. Simon, Heidi, and Alicia, if you had made any other choice, the results would have been very different. And you'll agree, there are many choices you could have made. However, Howie, you can see your photo is still there. At the beginning, I mentioned that you all would have certain acts that have stood out in your minds. Howie, who would be one of yours?
Don't be offended, but it's magic, it's Shin Lim.
Strangely, Howie, you didn't choose yourself, but instead you chose Shin Lim.
How is that even possible?
This was the ending I think most of us were expecting. But we must always expect the unexpected.
How's that possible?
Oh my goodness.
At the beginning. beginning, I said we can all be X if we want to be. And that includes...
I just got chills. Oh my God, no way!
I have chills.
That was fantastic.
It's like it was freaking me out. I couldn't believe it.
Okay, Simon.
What?
This.
What?
Would have been my golden buzzer.
Yeah.
But Simon likes dancing guys from space.
Don't blame me.
Mark, look, this is the third time we've met. I think it was probably your best performance we've seen from you so far.
Thank you.
I
really do.
I would put you through to the semi-finals in a heartbeat. I think it was spectacular what you just did.
Thank you. Thank you.
Hello.
Hello.
I know who you are, but introduce yourself to everybody here.
I'm Jasper Cherry, I'm 16 years old, and I'm from Lancashire in England. Yeah. Ah.
Jasper, how many years ago was it you were on BGT?
2 years ago.
2 years ago?
Yeah.
Okay, and you got how far?
I made it all the way to the finals.
When I first discovered magic, I was 9 years old. As a child, I was quite shy, so magic really helped. I was just mesmerized, and I learned as much as possible, and then started showing my family, my friends, and then I decided, you know what? Why not go and audition for Britain's Got Talent? The moment that I stepped onto that stage, I didn't know what to think. I was literally stood there in front of some of the most famous people in the world.
I'm simply taking a red handkerchief and pushing it into my fist. I'm then gonna snap my fingers and show, look, it's turned into an egg.
You, young man, have got a huge future ahead of you, I think.
Thank you.
Hearing that comment, that it was literally my biggest dreams ever.
But you didn't win.
I didn't win, no.
Why are you rubbing it in?
No, because I just want to know what you think you can maybe do differently today so that you will win.
Well, I think I'm a much more confident performer.
After Britain's Got Talent, my life completely changed. I got so many opportunities, like to perform at the Blackpool Magic Convention. That is the biggest magic convention in the world. I've been in magazines, I've been in newspapers all across the UK. So I'm definitely a better performer. America's Got Talent has had some of the best magicians on, so I'm feeling quite nervous, but I'm walking onto the stage this time with a lot more confidence. I am ready.
Now, tonight, I'm going to try and prove to you all that time travel really does exist, which I know is a crazy thing. And Heidi, please, can you come and join me up on stage and make sure you've got your cell phone with you too? Round of applause for Heidi. Come on, guys, keep it going. Heidi, you can take a seat. Thank you so much.
Yeah.
I've got a deck of cards here.
Okay.
And I need a favor from you. I want you to tell me when to stop. Right there?
Yep.
Okay. I want you to take that card.
Yep.
Show it round, and it doesn't matter if I see this card as well, because this is not a card trick. The five of spades. Make sure it's face up. Place it somewhere around the middle. There we go. Okay. Now, everyone, I want you to remember this moment right here, where all the cards were face down, apart from one, and that is your card, the Five of Spades.
Yes.
Now we'll do this again. I'm gonna take about half the cards face up and half the cards face down, and I'm gonna mix them together. There's a technical term for this, Heidi. It's called a mess.
A mess.
Now, Heidi, I want you to take the Five of Spades
yeah.
and turn it face down,
mm-hmm.
and then place it once again somewhere around the middle. Okay. Now, you've got your phone there, and I'm gonna take a picture of you. Is that okay?
Sure.
Perfect. I also want you to hold onto these cards. Okay, maybe use both hands. Make sure you don't drop them.
Nope.
Okay. And I want you to give me your best model face. So here we go. Perfect. I'll take the cards from you. All right. Audience, are you ready to prove that time travel really does exist? Okay, here we go then. And we're gonna use my phone for this. So here we go. I want you to watch closely as you will see the time start ticking back. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Heidi, we've just gone back in time. 5 minutes. I want you to look at your phone and show me the time on your phone as well.
Yeah, 6:45.
We've both gone back in time. 5 minutes. But that's not it. Audience, I want you to take your phones out right now. You have all just gone back in time. 5 minutes. If we really have gone back in time,
yeah.
then this deck of cards that was a mess should now have returned to the point that I asked you all to remember when they were all face down apart from the Five of Spades.
Yes, there it is.
There it is. Now, Heidi,
yes.
a few minutes ago we took a picture on your phone.
Yes.
So because we went back in time 5 minutes and the deck of cards has changed, that picture has also changed. So I want you to go to that picture.
Mm-hmm.
You can see that, Heidi, you are in fact holding a deck of cards that is all facing one way.
Yes.
Apart from your card, the Five of Spades. But Heidi, if I really could time travel, then why not go back more than 5 minutes? Why not go back before I even left my home in England? Then I'd know what your card was, the Five of Spades.
Yes.
And I did. And if you don't believe me, watch this. I'm leaving home right now to come to you guys in America. I am super excited to come and see you. It's currently 5 a.m. I'm just looking for the gate now. So, there it is. I'm on the plane now and I'm about to take my seat. I'm finally here at the airport in LA. I'm gonna go to the hotel and I'll see you very soon.
You went back.
Heidi, thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
Amazing. Wow.
Try this at home.
Hello. Back again.
This is so cool just to have me back. It's such a privilege.
Anyway, let's begin the show. What I have here, right, is a very small screw. And a bolt, right, as you see. Even to try it with your hands is pretty hard to turn it on. What I'm going to do, first of all, I'm going to swallow the tiny little bolt. Then I will pop in the screw. Perfect.
Oh.
Now, I'm going to put that little screw onto the bolt, but I'm going to make it harder. Do you want it on at the beginning? Would you like it on at the middle? Or would you like it on at the end? Tell me what. In the middle.
Middle.
Okay, we will do that for you in the middle. Now, it'll take a few seconds to do. Once I get it on, it'll move quick. It's just a getting it on. So let me do this for you now. I actually have the bolt pushed onto the screw. And all I've got to do now is just turn the little bolt. It's working. So open my tummy and you'll see it better.
Oh my God.
Right.
What is he doing?
I want to try and get it on as close to the center as possible. And we have it right on the center. No. I have here a small plum tomato. Now what I'm going to do is use this very sharp Stanley blade. Uh-oh. I'm going to swallow, first of all, the full tomato.
Oh, okay.
This is very, very sharp. I will let you see. I'm going to place this inside, beside the tomato, and I'm going to slice the tomato in half.
I can't watch this. I can't watch it.
Okay.
It's half. It's coming back up. There is a Stanley blade. And there we have the tomato.
My name is Oz Pearlman. I'm 37 years old. I live in New York City, and I'm a mentalist. As a kid, I knew how to observe people and gauging their reactions, know what they would do. But when I told my family my dream, which was being a mind reader and mentalist, they thought I was crazy. So I got a job at a major Wall Street bank. I would stare at my computer day in, day out, and think, is this the life I was meant to live? I decided no. I decided I'm gonna go for it. And so I left that cushy job to go for my passion, my dream.
Howie, the movie star you were focused in on was?
Tom Cruise.
So when I got the standing ovation and Heidi said to me, I want more, more, more.
More of us.
That's when I knew I made the right choice. And at a certain point, you start to think, I'm gonna win America's Got Talent.
The act finishing in third place is Oz Pearlman.
I was devastated, but despite not winning America's Got Talent, it launched my career into an entirely different level. I performed on stadiums for tens of thousands of people at once, for presidents, for you name the movie star, I've probably been at one of their parties. It's just unbelievable. But there's that one pesky box that I haven't checked, and that's winning.
It's great to see you, Oz.
You too, Howie.
You were on AGT 2015, and how did you do?
Third place.
You came in third place.
Over and over, I heard you should have won, so you know what? This is my moment to redeem.
Yes! Yes. Woo! I like that!
Take us there, buddy.
People ask me all the time, what was it like being on AGT? And I tell them two things. First, I promised myself that if I ever had the chance to perform for you judges and all of America again, I would savor every single moment. And the second thing I tell people is that America's Got Talent turned my life completely upside down in the best possible way. Because moments are what define us. Howie, Heidi, Alicia, close your eyes. Go back in time to a day, a month, a year. Focus on it and the emotional significance it played for you. Now, everyone in the audience, grab your wallet, take a bill, any bill you want, and hold it over your head. Let's get Terry out here to help us out. Terry Crews, everybody! Terry, go to any person you want and grab any bill.
Okay. You got a dollar? $1? Okay.
Please. Hand that to Simon, fold yes. It in half. Simon, fold it again in half, please. I never want to touch it, I don't want to see it. You know what, I don't even want you touching it. Place it in an envelope yourself. Push it all the way in there, all the way.
I'm
push
trying.
It. And hold it right here up in full view. Are all three of my other judges focused on that moment in your life? Mm-hmm. Heidi, you can't contain your joy. This is a very happy moment. Person, people, more than one. Are you thinking of five different people?
I am.
And I see them, four are your kids, and then one more. It's a man, he's on his knee. This is your engagement, am I right?
Yes.
Heidi, do
you have your phone?
I do.
Please go to the calculator. What I'd like you to do is you're gonna type in the day, the month, and then the year, please. Alicia, I saw you smile. I saw you relive this moment. Be honest. There's absolutely no way I could know what you're thinking of. Is that right?
Correct.
A word. What is the name in mind? What's associated with this memory?
Misty.
Are you being for real?
Yes, I'm for real.
Not even close. Dead on. Wow. But wait. What if we could combine two moments? Heidi, hit plus.
Mm-hmm.
And Alicia, what I'd like you to do is type in the day, the month, and then the four-digit year. Go ahead, please.
Okay, don't touch anything else.
Well, that's how we add them together.
Okay.
Heidi.
Yes?
Tell me, what are your two moments combined?
Five.
Five.
Eight.
Eight.
Two.
Two.
Zero. Nine. Zero, six, one.
Zero, six, and one. Howie, you have a moment that you're focused on.
Okay.
Focus on the significance. Oh my, it's getting hot and heavy.
Woo!
What is the day?
The 16th.
The month?
March.
03. What year?
80.
Heidi.
Yes.
Let's combine your three moments. Hit the plus. Now type in 1603198 0. Hit equals. Okay, so Terry, you could have taken any bill. Simon, you've been holding it throughout. Open up that bill. Every bill is printed with a unique serial number. Please read me that number.
Seven.
Seven.
Four.
Four. Next.
Two.
Two.
No.
Four.
Four.
One.
One.
Zero.
Zero.
Four.
Yes.
One.
Remember what I told you, the two things I tell everybody. America's Got Talent turned my life completely upside down. Oh, and I want to savor every moment.
That's for real.
Wow.
Good evening.
I can't believe it. Wow.
Welcome to America's Got Talent. What is your name?
My name is Mervant.
And where are you from, Mervant?
I'm from Philadelphia, PA. Philly in the house, baby. Philly in the house.
And what do you do?
I am a magician.
You're a magician?
Oh. I'm a magician.
How old are you? How old are you?
I am 33 years old.
You make a living doing magic now?
I do my best.
What got you into magic?
You know, watching magic, it kind of made me feel like you have a real superpower, you know, like growing up. And I always loved comics and stuff, and that's the closest thing, right? Being a magician, so, yeah.
What does this mean to you? Why AGT?
You know, if you can do it on this stage, you can do it anywhere.
Yeah.
I've been watching this on television for years, and to possibly have a Vegas show, to tour the world, it'd be a dream come true. It really would.
And do you have any support? Does your family support this?
My family does. They've been absolutely wonderful. You know, this past year, I lost my grandmother. She was one of my biggest supporters in magic. I remember a couple years ago, I wanted to quit magic, and she said, "Don't you dare ever do that."
Aww.
And even at times when I wasn't performing a lot of shows, I always practice. And this is a testament to stick-to-itiveness, and I'm happy to be here.
Good for you. Good for you. The stage is yours.
Let's do it.
He is nervous as can be.
America's Got Talent. My name is Mervant, and I know you've seen a lot of magic on this show, but I want to show you something you've never seen with the deck of cards. I want you to watch each and every card closely, because I have a little story for you. And it goes like this. 52 cards. Check it out. It goes one for the magic, two for illusion,
Three for the fact I can mix them both with a fusion. Four for the suits of the playing cards that I'm using. So I'ma be the only one performer who would do this. Five finger discounts led me to do some sleight of hand. I got a sixth sense for this. It's like I'm Spider-Man. Seven different wonders of the world. There's some great ones. Magic, music, illusion. I'm trying to be the eighth one. We make classes. It's the fly version of Di Vernon. Look close and talking eyes burning. This is just another lesson. I'm lucky like number seven. Wouldn't believe this rap had five virgins, but the sixth set may be the best yet. You know why? Cause I wear a king suit. No tie, blindfolds on. My flourishes done with no eyes. Card disappear like in front of your nose. I got one heart for two arts, so I have to grind. Otherwise, I'd be sitting around feeling asinine. Jack of all trades, gold thoughts that I have to mine. Always trying to change my 210s, that's a paradigm. A paradigm's I probably go see ya. Paradigms like Heidi and Sophia. I'm a showman, so allow me to show you how I'm good with the jokes like Howie. Doing this for Simon so the world might hear me. Cruise to the top and get jacked like Terry. So, whether you were born a jack, a queen, or an ace, a raise as a diamond, joke, a spade, or an eight. It's 7 billion people in the world and we're all connected. The different colors of the globe as the cards reflected. We're all from the same box when the cards collected. So if the deck is incomplete, then we're all affected. Be like the 7 to the Q and the 8-3 to be like playing cards and spread L-O-V-E.
Thank you.
The reason that I'm a psychic today is because of my aunt. She used to host these tea parties where she'd read tea leaves, psychically divining questions and concerns from members of the public. And I'd like to show you what one of those is like tonight. But I'll obviously need some guests. So Terry Crews, who would come out here and join me? Terry Crews, everyone, give him a round of applause. Hello, Terry. I want you to pick a member of our audience to join us during this. So look at our beautiful audience and then...
How about you, the young lady right there? Yes, yes.
Join us on stage. Give her a lovely round of applause. Up you come. And then, Terry, if you want to go and sit on that far seat for me, Howie Mandel, will you join me on stage
You're
as well?
Get
Everyone,
into
give
my
Howie
mind.
A big round of applause. Up you come, Howie. You want to sit just down there. So when people come to psychic tea parties like this, they tend to ask a question they don't know the answer to. And Howie, that's exactly the sort of question I'd like you to think of right now. I'm gonna look away. I want you to write that question nice and clearly on that piece of paper so you can show the other judges. And just let me know as soon as you're finished with that.
I've got it.
You got it?
I do.
Perfect. Will you show the other judges? I'll keep looking, Wayne. And then as soon as you've done that, I want you to take that piece of paper, tear it up and throw it in the teapot in front of you.
It's a lot of work.
So your question's gonna brew with the tea now.
Okay.
Which basically means that I...
Oh.
...can drink your question and figure out what it is. Okay, so straight away, you're normally like a comedic person, and I get the vibe that this is about your family, isn't it?
Absolutely.
It's Alex, isn't it? You're thinking of Alex, your son.
Yes.
Yes. And this is something you tease him about a lot because you want to know whether he's going to find someone to marry, don't you?
Well, yes.
Whoa.
I saw that.
Now, the second question that people ask psychics is questions that they know the answer to, and they're looking for me to prove my psychic skills. That's why I asked Terry to bring you on stage, someone that none of us has ever met before. Your name is?
Grace.
Grace, lovely to meet you, Grace. Now, Grace, I want you to get a question in mind that if I knew the answer to, would convince you that I was psychic.
Okay.
So, have you got something in mind?
Yes.
Yes, perfect. Okay, I want you to put your left index finger in your tea for me. And I just want you to think about that question, okay? So, right.
I'm thinking.
Okay, right, you can take your finger out. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
And I will try this.
Oh.
Grace, you've already decided what your child's name should be, haven't you?
Yes.
Yes, good, okay. Look forward for me, and in a second, out loud for everyone, say the name that you want to name your child. Keep your eyes forward, no peeking. Out loud for everyone. What do you want to name your child?
Summer.
Oh,
Summer.
No.
Whoa. Now, Terry.
Yeah.
So I want you to get your question in mind now.
Okay.
And then I want you to pick up your cup of tea and just hold it in between two hands. I'm going to reach around you so I can hold your hands. This is for the psychic demonstration. Also.
Oh, my goodness.
That's fine. We'll keep going. Okay. Okay, Simon, Terry's slightly harder to read, and I don't want to get this wrong because we... Okay, we'll try this. My aunt always said, when you're not sure of something in life, you'll find the answer at the bottom of a cup of tea. Terry, what was your question?
What size are my shoes?
What size are your shoes?
One of a kind.
One of a kind. And for everyone here, what size are your shoes?
14.
14.
Oh, no! This is size 14.
Kidding me?
Wow.
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 Thank you so much, Terry, Grace, Harry. Good night.
I have a lot to say, but before I say anything, why? I think you are 100% wrong, Simon.
I tell you what, because it's not always about the finish, it's getting there. And how you got there wasn't very good, in my opinion, because it takes too long. And I think it's your lack of showmanship.
Really?
Yeah, I really, really do.
I disagree. I think you have great showmanship.
Thank you so much.
I'm telling you, it is so exciting to have somebody read your mind. What he did is like a superpower.
Agree. I was there. I saw it.
If I have to say anything negative, it's the fact that the superfans only have one choice from each evening to go through to the finals. If it was up to me, that was an act that I think is worthy, you don't agree with me, but is worthy of the final.
I agree.
And I can't wait to see what you would do next.
I love you, and I'm so happy that you're back.
Okay, thank you very much.
Thank you so much, guys.
Simon, man.
I think he's impatient. He's got a short attention span. He wants it straight away. And you know, psychic powers takes time. He always says that he believes in magic, but magic isn't instant.
I don't think so.
I think really Simon's scared about what I know about him. So maybe if you see me in the final, I would.
Good to see everyone here, man. It's crazy.
So to everyone who doesn't know you, please introduce yourself again.
Right. My name is Eric Chien, and I am a magician.
Yes.
A great magician.
A great magician.
When I was little, I was like the only Asian in school, and I did get bullied a lot. I was really shy. My English was really bad. But when I fell in love with magic, I discovered that it was a great coping mechanism. I decided to pursue magic as my career, so I auditioned for America's Got Talent.
Oh my God. Yeah. Whoa, whoa.
When I looked up, everyone was on their feet. It was such an amazing feeling. I had goosebumps. Even right now, thinking about it, I have goosebumps.
I think you're one of the best we've ever had.
Simon Cowell is a very tough judge. During the live show, he said,
I'm getting a little bit bored of the close-up magic.
You've got to do something big.
But I did not follow his advice.
I would say your definition of what's big and my definition of big is slightly different.
The next act going into the finals is Benicio Bryant!
Not taking his advice definitely hurt me in the AGT run, but I'm glad that I didn't. After AGT, I was able to perform everywhere. I traveled to like 10 different countries. I was on Broadway. I was living my dream life, performing close-up magic. But I didn't win AGT. I'm here to show Simon and America why I deserve to be an All-Star. Heidi,
yes.
Please come join me on stage.
On stage. Again.
Have a seat here. Hello.
Wow, you're much taller than I thought you were.
Good to see you. I'm excited. I get to see this right here.
Okay, here we go.
It's funny how the magic of life plays itself out. So many things in my life have been because of a second chance. I was really proud of my first performance on Champions.
Leaving the competition is Jon Dorenbos!
Playing in the NFL, I was taught that when you lose, you figure it out. What could I have done differently that would have got me that extra vote, that maybe would have sent me through? And then all of a sudden, I got the call, and I'm the wild card.
He's been through so much in his life, from losing his parents at such a young age to losing his dream of being a professional football player because he almost died of a heart aneurysm. John is such a fighter. It makes me so proud to be his wife and to stand next to him.
I've been a wild card my whole life. I believe that everything happens for a reason, and I believe that there's magic everywhere.
And now to have a second chance here.
I know that I'm in the right spot and that I'm doing what I'm meant to be doing. I'm here to win it.
Here's the deal. I got four chalkboards. They're numbered 1, 2, 3, and 4. Now, Simon, Heidi, Mel, Howie, you guys are going to choose which chalkboard is going to represent you guys. So, hey, you don't know what's behind there. I've drawn something and I've written some stuff on each one. We're going to get to it in a little bit. So, Simon.
Well, you obviously want... number one.
Okay, number one it is. Simon, number one. Heidi, guess what? Same thing. Do you want 2, 3, or 4?
Yeah, I would like to be the number two then.
Number two it is. You guys are making this easy on me. Mel B, 3 or 4?
I will go for the number 3.
Threes it is. Mel B.
Oh, I know what I want to be.
Howie, my man, number 4. Now, you guys had a free choice. This is what I love about this show. This show changed my life. Howie, you've toured the country, man. You've toured the world. You've sold out venues all over the place.
Right.
And I want to be just like you. So I actually got cities off of your tour schedule. So here's a bunch of cities and states of places that you've performed that I want to perform one day.
Okay.
So we're going to pick one right now. When I riffle, say stop. Are you ready?
Yes.
Say stop.
Stop riffling.
You want to keep going or do you want that?
No, I want to stop.
Are you sure?
I really need to stop.
Okay, hey. Here you go. Don't look at it.
Okay.
Slide it out. Keep it right there.
All right.
I started AGT doing a card trick. So Mel B, we're going to do just that. I'm going to do a card trick. I'm going to make it really simple on you. All you're going to do is, as I riffle through here, all you got to do is say stop. Are you ready? So just say stop.
Stop.
Right here. Watch carefully. I'm going to rip a corner. Like so. Queen of hearts. Hold on the queen, Mel. Heidi, let me see your hand. It's when you take the corner that corner disappears. Just like that. Gone. Now there's a stack of pictures that have been sitting right here. I haven't touched them. I haven't come close to them. Nope. Why don't we pick up all those pictures and see if there's something underneath right there.
Pick up everything?
Pick them all up. You're gonna find one thing. No. There's a corner to a card right there. Now hold on, Mel B. Take that corner. Make sure it fits perfect right there.
I don't wanna touch it.
Get it.
She's got nails.
Howie to the rescue.
Yeah, there we go.
Make sure it fits perfect right there.
And
that is in fact the corner. Now, Heidi. I love this. Heidi, your whole career, you've done outrageous. What is this?
Well, I'm a witch, obviously.
And Halloween, you go over the top. But these are pictures of you, whether it's Halloween, whether it's red carpets. It's just all the cool events that you've been able to go to.
Yeah.
And guess what? You're going to do the same thing Howie did. All you're going to do, as I riffle, is just say stop.
Just light my hand in it?
If whatever you want.
Alrighty.
I'm ready when you are. Whoop. Okay, don't look at it.
Not looking.
Slide it over just like this. Simon, I got a deck of cards here. All you got to do is just touch one. Just touch it. Now look, hold on. I'm gonna give you the opportunity. Do you wanna keep this one or do you wanna change your mind?
I'll keep it.
Are you sure?
Yeah.
Remember this moment. I'm giving you a chance to change your mind.
No, I'm gonna keep it.
Here it is.
Thank you. Take it.
And look at it if you want. Howie, what did you pick?
Turn it over.
Show everybody what it is. You and I are going somewhere, buddy. And where is it?
Tulsa, Oklahoma.
There it is. Let me see it. Tulsa, Oklahoma. The judges had a free choice of whatever chalkboard they wanted. Hey, Terry, can you do me a favor? There's a chalkboard with Howie's face on there. Why don't you go ahead and turn that chalkboard around for me, man? Because I drew something on that chalkboard. Howie, you and I are going to Tulsa, Oklahoma. Mel B, you could have selected any card you wanted to. You chose the Queen of Hearts. Terry, spin that thing around for me. I had a premonition that not only would she choose that chalkboard, but you were going to pick a Queen of Hearts.
That's crazy.
Heidi.
How is that even possible?
You've done a lot of cool things in your career. What did you do today with that picture?
I was a schmetterling for Halloween. I was a butterfly for Halloween.
That's a butterfly?
Yeah.
That's amazing. You chose number two. Terry, do me a favor. Turn over number two. I made a prediction and drew a picture before the show that you were going to be a butterfly. Now, hold on. We got one left. Simon, I told you there was a defining moment when you could have changed your mind and you said, no.
Yeah.
You picked a card.
I did.
What do you got? Three of clubs. You had the first choice. You could have chosen any chalkboard you wanted. One, two, three, or four. My man went with number one. I wrote a card on the back of that chalkboard. Terry, let me see it, my man.
All right.
Turn that around. There's the three of clubs. Thank you. But hold on. Howie, in the quarterfinals of America's Got Talent, I had a huge map on that stage. Roll that clip.
No.
Just like that, Howie, in season 11, you chose Oklahoma.
That's Oklahoma.
Just like you did today.
How's that possible?
Mel B, you chose any card you wanted to, and you chose a heart. Hearts follow you everywhere you go, because in the first round of America's Got Talent, the champions, I asked the audience to write words of what described a champion. You could have chosen any words you wanted to. You selected whatever words you wanted, and lo and behold, the words you chose, heart. Predicted back then, and there's your heart. Now, Heidi.
My God.
I believe it was the semifinal, season 11. I sat up here and I had all you guys think of whatever you wanted and you could draw whatever you want. And in season 11, I made a prediction that today, you'd go back to that Halloween party as a butterfly. Right there, you drew a butterfly.
Whoa!
Now, hold on. The moment it comes down to, I wanted to end my journey the same way I started. Because in season 11, when he just thought of any card he wanted to, my man Simon picked a three of clubs right there, just like he picked today. And I ended the same way I started with Simon Cowell holding the three of clubs. My name's Jon Dorenbos, baby. It's a great day to be alive. Peace out. I love every single one of you. Thank you guys, my man.
Jon Dorenbos! Come up here, man.
Heidi,
yes.
Your thoughts?
I mean, you are multi-talented. You really, really are. I mean, you speak from the heart and you boost our spirit every time when you come onto the stage. You're so entertaining, you're so good.
Simon.
You've come back and just blown the roof off with what I've just seen.
Yes.
I mean, genuinely, I'm not just saying that, John. We're not voting, the 50 states are voting. You have a shot.
Thank you.
I mean, that was amazing.
Thank you.
I mean, purely fantastic.
Yeah, awesome, man.
Howie, your thoughts?
Oh my gosh, I'm like just stunned. I really am. There are only two words to describe what you did tonight, and that is wild card.
My gosh.
You are a champ.
I'll take it, baby.
Now, John, being a wild card tonight, how do you feel about coming back?
Let me tell you, I'm gonna share something with you guys for the first time because my wife and I haven't told anybody. And before this show a few days ago, magic happened. We got a bun in the oven and this guy right here is about to be a dad. Yeah. And my wife's out there, baby. I love you. And a little Dorenbos is going to be running around here, so take cover.
Well, good luck tonight, John. Thank you. Please give it up for Jon Dorenbos.
Hey, everyone. It's great to be here. Simon.
Yes.
When you were a kid in the 1870s, did you have flashcards?
I did.
They used to help me read, and now they even help me read minds. I know, spooky. So, here they are, the 26 letters of the alphabet,
yep.
All with their own individual image. So, can you tell me when to stop, please, whenever you want?
Okay. Stop!
Oh, are you sure?
Yep.
All right, great. So take this card, don't look at it, and we'll get back to it in a second.
Thank you, Aidan.
Thank you. Heidi.
Yes?
I want you to look into my eyes.
Ooh.
Now, I do this to create a strong connection with the person. But in your case, I just wanted to look into your eyes. Heidi, you gave me the gift of the golden buzzer.
Yes.
So I brought you a gift.
Aww.
But you can't open it yet.
Okay.
We'll leave it right there.
Thank you.
Because in only one of those balloons, I have a prediction. A card that hopefully matches your card. And if you get it right, you can open your gift. And I'll need someone to help me on stage. Someone charming. Charismatic. Handsome, funny,
yes.
Known all around the world. So where are you, Terry? Come on out. Terry, as always, you're looking nearly as buff as me. Keep going to the gym, hang in there. You'll get these bad boys soon enough.
He's so funny.
Terry, I want you to hold on to these darts for me. So Simon, you'll go first. Pick a balloon you don't think that my prediction's in.
Pink.
Pink. All right. Terry, throw the dart at the pink balloon.
All right.
Let's see. And you were right. Terry, no card.
That's it.
Howie, it's your turn now. I know, tough choice. They all look a lot like you. But try to pick a balloon. Pick a balloon you don't think my prediction is in.
Yellow.
Terry, pop the yellow balloon. You were right. No card. Heidi.
Yes.
No pressure. If you do this wrong, my trick is ruined and it will be a long flight back to Arden. So, green or blue balloon, which one do you want Terry to pop?
Blue.
Terry, pop the blue balloon. Let's see. And you were all right. No card, which must mean my prediction's in this balloon. All right, here we go. Terry, can you hear this?
I can hear it.
That's my prediction. Pop the balloon. Look it, a card came out. Terry, show everyone what that card is.
It is...
an octopus. Simon, for the first time, show everyone what card you chose.
Yes!
It's an octopus! Thank you so much, Terry. You've been great.
Thank you.
Now, Heidi.
I can open it?
Well, since you got it right, you can open it. What's in there?
An octopus.
A purple octopus! Now, to prove that I knew it was octopus from the very beginning, everybody, look up!
golden buzzer.
Yes. I mean, you are as confident and as skilled as a grown magician. You really are, but it's just much cuter when you do it. It really is. We're gonna get this all the way. Why not? Let's win this thing! That was so good!
Simon!
Yeah, I just think you need a bit more confidence. No, that was actually quite amazing. You've got an amazing personality. I mean, honestly, incredible. Everyone tonight has been fantastic.
I agree.
Thank you.
Howie.
Yeah, I agree with what my fellow judges said. The magic was impeccable. And you have such a stage presence. You're a great comedian, you're a great performer, and you're a great magician. And most of all, you're an all-star.
Thank you.
Well, thank you, Aidan. Aidan has done all he can. It's now up to the super fans to decide if he should be our All-Stars champion. We'll get the result in next week's finale. For now, make some noise for Aidan McCann!
Thanks for my presence!
Thank you. Bye, guys. Thank you.
He's just adorable.
It's one thing to remember the magic, but how does he remember all those jokes? And when things happen, he thinks on his feet. He's a good improv artist.
Hello. Oh, we're not going to talk again, are we?
I remember she has said...
Sacred Riana.
You never talk to me, do you? Well, let me do the talking for you. Your first name is Sacred, and your second name is Riana. Riana.
The horror is real.
I actually want this to end right now.
Me too. The next act going into the semifinals is Duo Transcend!
I'm not finished yet.
You know what I do remember about her?
What?
Her act was one of the most viral acts of all time. Oh, no. Not toward me. Oh, my gosh.
Ice cold.
Pick one. Don't look.
Not a match.
Yeah?
Uh-oh.
Oh, no.
Come if you want to play.
Breaking
up on your door. with me.
Well, I don't.
Oh, man. Howie, be careful.
Guys?
Bye, Howie.
He's still here.
It's moving.
Taking the ashes.
He's gone for now. But he already knows your name, Howie.
Howie? Did you guys hear that? There's a voice saying Howie. Just me? I swear to you. Okay. All right. I'm just.
Take the knives out.
Oh no! It says I'm coming for you, Howie. Where'd she go? Oh my gosh!
Where did she go?
Great.
What happened? I don't.
Is it over?
I'm coming for you, Howie. Okay.
Are we at the end of that?
Thank you.
Is everyone as confused as I am?
I don't know what's going on.
Apparently somebody's coming for me, so I would like to get the judging out of the way and so that I can leave.
I don't know what to say. Has it finished?
No, I don't think it's finished.
I'm finished.
Has it finished?
I really, legitimately, I'm not kidding. I'm telling you that I'm terrified.
Terrified of what?
Read the notes!
I mean, Howie's terrified because someone is coming for
I
Howie.
I was poked in the back. I was
good.
Stabbed in the back.
We're good.
He knows my name, and he's coming for me. Is that judging? Have we done what we're paid to do?
Yes. Very good.
Let's move on with the show, then. Let's see another act. Something that'll get rid of...
That gets rid of the juju vibe.
Yeah.
From BGT.
I'm Howie.
Top.
Hello.
Hello, Simon. Do you remember me?
Of course I remember you. You and I have met. Tell us who you are. What's the dream?
Okay, my name is Keiichi Iwasaki, and I have been traveling with bicycle. Yeah, I'm very happy to be here.
Okay, so why are you here?
No, because it's a big, big opportunity to show my magic all over the world.
All right, good luck, Keiichi.
Yeah, thank you. Arigatou gozaimasu.
Arigato.
Yep.
He's already making me laugh.
He's very funny.
Here we go.
Hello, Simon.
Hi, Keiichi.
Hello, Howie.
Hello.
Okay, yep. I have two handkerchiefs here. Okay, please.
Okay.
Could you make a knot? Is it possible?
It is possible.
Yeah, yes, please make a knot.
But you're doing it.
Yes. Very tight, please.
Okay.
Very tight, please.
Okay. Right.
Okay. Then, one more time, please.
Another
knot. Make sure tight. Okay. Yes.
And you dance too.
Yeah. Very tight, please.
I know.
Very tight, huh?
I'm doing it tight.
Simon, do you want to check it? Please check it.
We do.
Yes, put boss tight, short and tight. And it's very tight.
That's a knot.
Okay, that's a knot. Now, usually it's how long does it take to untie it?
2 minutes, 3 minutes.
No, maybe 3 days. But give me a hand like this.
What?
Open like this.
It is.
Then just put it. Hold here. Hold. Yes.
Hold it.
But don't move. It's very dangerous. Okay?
Okay.
Don't move.
Okay.
What the? Open your hand.
What happened?
Open your hand. Here you go. Next magic is this one. What the?
Whoa.
I need a LED light from here.
What?
Sorry, here. No, Heidi, in here. Sorry, excuse me. No, Simon, open your mouth. Nini. Hang it up. No. In the ear.
It's in my ear.
Like a little bit like this. Okay, now. Again. No.
I love this guy.
Heidi, could you come join me to the stage?
Yes.
Thank you.
You're tall.
Yes.
Sorry. Yes, my last trick is this. This is what? Blind hood. So can you see anything?
Well, now I can. You want me to put it on? Yes.
No, I can't see it.
No, okay. I can't see through
okay.
it.
Okay.
Okay.
Now, I put this like this.
Oh, you want it.
Yes. Now, I make like this. Give me a finger like this. Is it okay? Can I touch this?
You can touch it.
Yes.
I'm not like Howie.
Okay. Sorry. Then, I have a ring. Okay. Can I put one this here? Okay. Please, don't move. It's a very difficult magic tricks.
I won't move.
Okay.
Okay.
Give me a ring. Okay. Please don't move. It's
I'm not moving.
Incredibly difficult. This ring from here. Without watching, 1, 2, 3. Oh, is it flying? I can see it.
It's spinning.
Okay, now it's just like this, okay? Uncle, also like this. Okay, now it's a passing.
Wow, that is weird.
Heidi, don't move.
I'm not moving.
Huh? It's a direct water.
Oh my goodness.
Amazing. How far did you go at BGT?
Semi-final. But the judge's choice was not me.
Right, they didn't
choose. I remember.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Simon was there.
Is the idea that you want to redeem yourself?
Yes, of course.
Because I think the super fans are going to love you. I love
you.
Yeah, I loved you already. You're super excited, which is getting me excited too, because you like high speed and you're moving things around. Then I was right there with this ring, was amazing.
Yeah.
I love you.
I love you too.
Well, yeah, I mean, look, I've always liked you because a lot of magicians do take themselves very seriously on this show. And they are quite boring with their little card tricks and stuff like that. You, however, have a personality. People are going to like you. Let's see what happens. Funny.
No. not only is he funny, the magic is amazing. Yes, that trick with the ring was amazing.
Good evening.
Hello.
Hello.
Who are you, beautiful girl?
I'm Mandy Muden. I'm from London in the United Kingdom.
How old are you?
I'm 29.
Ah.
It's been a rough couple of years, you know what I mean?
And what do you do, Mandy?
I do magic.
Why AGT? Now?
Well, being British, as Simon will back me up to say, I love America. Also, I owe money and had to get out of the UK.
What are you going to do with $1 million if you win?
Well, I'd probably spend it on men.
On men? Okay, we're ready for you. We want to see your magic.
Okay, fantastic. Right, everybody, are you ready to get into a magic mood? Okay, America's Got Talent. Look at this. Four strangers ready to judge me. It's like one of those parties where you throw the car keys into the fishbowl. Heidi,
yes?
Would you just... I've got a bag here full of letters. Could you just reach in and get a few out just to make sure that they're all different? It's very difficult with the gloves on, isn't it? If you just committed a crime and hoping to get away with it.
They all look different.
Lovely. Shove that back. I'll give the bag a bit of a shake. Hi, Howie.
Hi.
I want you just to take a letter.
One?
Don't look at it.
Okay.
Okay, fantastic. Could you take one as well?
Take it out?
Yes, please. And don't look at it. We'll come back to that later. Okay, Sophia, could you do the same? Okay, fantastic. Now, Simon, I'm going to riffle through my book. Could you just stick anything in you like?
Finger?
Yes, a finger would be lovely, Simon. Okay, brilliant. Now, Simon, could you look at the page number?
Yes.
And the first word on the page, Simon.
Got it.
Okay, and could you write them down and remember them?
Yes, I can.
Okay, fantastic. I'm just going to pop back up to the stage. Feel free to check me out, Simon. Okay. Right, here we go. Now, Howie, I want you to think of any word at all in the English language.
Okay.
Now, would you be impressed if the word you were thinking of was written on a piece of paper in the bag in front of you?
Yes, more than impressed.
Please open the bag.
It's a dictionary.
Unbelievable. Heidi and Sophia, open your packages. Okay, Heidi, what lovely love story do you have, Heidi?
Mine says 50 Shades of Grey.
Oh, now Simon, what page were you on?
70.
Okay, Heidi, could you turn to page 70? I'm just going to go into a trance and read your mind. Here we go. Page 70. Does your word begin with an F?
Yes.
Right, lovely. Now, are you familiar with this word?
Yes, I'm familiar with the word.
Okay. Now, the spirits are telling me that this word ends in I-N-G, okay? Have you done this word today?
Yes.
That's my girl, fantastic. Is your word by any chance, is it fantasizing?
Yes, it is.
Okay, now, Sophia, could you go to 17? Could you look at the last word on page 70, Sophia?
I don't have my glasses. 70.
Okay, Howie, you've got a dictionary there.
Yes.
Could you go to page 330?
Okay.
And could you go down 7 word entries?
7 words. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
What's the word?
Loony.
No! It's loony!
Now, Simon, you were thinking of a word, you wrote it down. What was your word?
Eat.
Eat. Howie, you picked a letter.
Could
you
I did.
Hold your letter up and shout it out?
It's an E.
An E. E. What do you have there, Heidi?
I have an A.
And what do you have, Sophia?
A T.
Unbelievable! Thank you
surprise.
Oh.
You're so funny, and I didn't expect to have so much fun. Howie.
You're a very good magician. You're funny. I love you. I'm a huge fan of yours. You are the epitome of somebody that deserves to have their own show. I would go see you in Las Vegas.
Yes. Oh, wow. Thank you so much. Thank you.
Heidi!
I think that you are adorable. And can I keep this?
Yes, of course.
Simon.
We saw everything, didn't we? I mean, you were mind reading. You were funny. You're very naughty. I really like you.
Oh, thank you.
I do.
So we're gonna vote. Heidi.
It's a yes from me for Mandy.
Oh, thank you so
Simon.
Much.
Simon.
It's a yes.
Howie.
Three yeses.
Oh, four yeses.
Oh, thank you so much. That's amazing.
Thank you.
She is really good.
I'm absolutely in shock. That was amazing. I couldn't believe what Howie said. It was like, he's such a hero of mine. I was like, oh my God.
She is great.
Thank you so much. Celebrate.
Thank you.
Hello, welcome, welcome, welcome.
What is your name?
My name is Ryland.
How old are you?
I'm 10 years old.
And where are you from?
I'm from England.
So Ryland, okay. Oh yes, he's from England, we know. What is your talent, young man?
Well, I'm a magician.
Ooh.
Wow.
How long you've been doing that?
Since I was 2, so 8 years.
Wow.
At 2?
I was born with magical powers, and my dad is a magician, and he gave me some of the magical powers that he didn't need anymore.
Wow. Okay. And what about the $1 million? If you get it, what would you do with that?
I'll give some to my mom, my sister, and my dad, and spend the rest on Legos.
Ah! Okay.
Okay. Let's see what you've got tonight.
Thank you. Tonight, I would like you to help me create a brand new magic word.
Okay. A magic word.
But first, I have gifts. You see, I love drawing and colouring in, and I've drawn you each a picture to look at later. This one's for you, Howie.
All right.
This one's for you, Heidi.
Thank you.
This one's for you, Sophia, and this one's for you, Simon. Now, don't peek inside the envelopes. Don't let anyone else touch them. We'll get back to them later. What you're about to see is amazing, but I can't do it on my own. I need help. Luckily, I have lots of friends that love magic just like me.
Oh, hello there. Hi, friends.
We got a lot of friends.
Wow. I'll let each of you to pick one of my friends, pick one of the numbers, and I'll place it in this holder. You get to choose which position it goes in. There are multiple combinations, and the choices are all yours. We'll start with you, Howie. Please name one of my friends.
Me? Marc.
And would you like the number 7 or 23?
I'll take 7, it's lucky.
And where would you like it to go? 1, 2, 3, or 4?
First, because I'm first.
Okay, so number 1. Heidi, it's your turn.
I choose
Would you like 11 or 26?
11.
And where would you like that to go? 2, 3, or 4?
4.
Thank you, Heidi. Sophie, it's your turn. Which of my friends would you like?
Skylar.
And would you like 24 or 10?
10.
And where would you like it to go? 2 or 3?
2.
Thanks, Sophia. And Simon, which of my friends would you like?
Jordan.
Jordan. And would you like 1 or 15? 1. And we'll try something a little bit different with you. Would you like to put it in last position or swap it out for another one? Okay.
He's taking my position.
Okay. Thanks, Simon. Now, let's look at the drawings you didn't use. As you can see, they're all different. We've got things like Lego, dragons, we've got burgers. So they're all different, yeah?
Yes.
Let's look at the drawings you did choose. You chose a snake, a slice of lime, a house, and some mountains. Each of you had a free choice of which drawing you wanted, and more importantly, where to put it. The snake looks like an S, the lime looks like a C, the house looks like an A, and the mountains look like an M. That spells the word scam, right?
Right.
Yeah.
I said that earlier, we're gonna create a brand new magic word. That can be our magic word. Everyone shout scam as loud as they can on the count of three. One, two, three.
Scam!
But what if I told you that we knew what the magic word would be before you even picked it? At the beginning of my act, I gave you each a drawing to hold on to. I'd like to take the drawing out of the envelope and show it to everyone. As you can see, they match. Now, as well as having something on the front of their t-shirt, my friends also had something on the back. Look. Word equals scam. Now, look.
Okay, so I'm at AGT. I'm gonna go in, do what I need to do, and get out as fast as I can. Okay, let's go. I can't believe I'm actually inside the AGT theatre. Right, there's a desk. Better be quick, can't get caught.
What is he doing?
Someone there. Oh God, someone's gonna hate this. What's that? Oh my God, I've got one. Come on.
Now, you're probably wondering what I did at the desk, Simon. Well, hopefully you're not too mad. Watch this.
It says scam everywhere.
Look, scam, 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 scam. Sorry, Simon.
Whoa. Woo! Hello.
Hello.
What's your name?
Magic Mike Jacobson.
Magic Mike Jacobson. So you're going to be doing magic.
That's right.
Well, what a coincidence to have that name and to be doing
pretty
what
convenient.
You do.
Yeah, yeah. The movie was loosely based on my life.
Okay. Now, how long have you been doing magic?
I like did magic everywhere I could, from like my home to barbershops and everywhere in between, and eventually kind of just like rose and rose and rose, and would love to keep doing it, you know? So that's perfect.
Okay. And how old are you?
36.
36. And where are you from?
L.A.
And how do you make a living? Do you make a living doing magic?
Not yet. I work in advertising by day, but this performance will determine whether I can quit.
Oh.
So we'll see what happens.
No pressure.
Yeah, no big deal. But actually a huge deal for me.
Well, let's see what you do. Are you nervous?
Exactly, let's see.
Yeah, I'm a little nervous. I'm also just excited to be here.
Well, wish you the best of luck, buddy.
Thank you.
Go ahead.
I'm gonna share something with you all tonight that every magician has, but no magician will show you for some reason. It's this. It's an invisible deck of cards. It's a bit hard to see in this light. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna burn the invisible deck from 52 all the way down to 1. At the end, Simon, you're gonna be a hero, as you always are in my heart. You're gonna save one of the remaining cards from Bernie, but it depends on what Heidi and Sophia decide. Heidi, take that match. I don't want you to strike it and stare into the flame. Let's just say there's two groups, number cards and face cards. We need to decide whether you want to start to burn all the numbers or all the faces. Blow it out when you're ready.
Am I telling you?
Yes, please.
All the faces.
The faces are now on the fire. You can pass the box over to Sophia. Sophia, take your match, okay? Left in the fire, we've got jacks, queens, kings. Okay, the only way to divide those up would be, yeah, men and women. We need to burn that match. And tell us, do you want to burn all the men? Do you want to burn all the women to a crisp?
Oh, the men.
That was a very quick decision. You go ahead, you blow it out. And you can pass that to Simon. You're gonna save one of the remaining cards for burning. All we have left are the four queens. Queen of hearts, queen of spades, queen of clubs, queen of diamonds. We're gonna light that match. And whenever you're ready, blow it out. I want you to draw with that match the suit of the queen that you want to save. Hearts, spades, clubs, or diamonds. Is that a diamond? Here's the thing, are you sure? Simon, if you shake the matchbox, do you hear something in there? Open that up for us. Because in all of your hands the entire time, there's been nothing but one card sitting inside there, protected by a paperclip. I want you to make sure, singed, like it's been in a bit of a fire. You guys could have saved whatever you wanted to, but you and you and you decided together to save the Queen of Diamonds.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you.
No.
I appreciate that very much, but this is America's Got Talent. I'm here to take this to the next level. And so, Howie, I don't know if you noticed, but there's an invisible deck of cards right next to your cup. Howie, if you would, I want you to just shuffle the deck for me, please. Or you might want to take it out of the box first. Oh. Thank you.
Stupid me.
Great. And now feel free to show off all your shuffling skills. Just make sure it's really mixed. Oh my God.
Oh wow.
That was very impressive.
He's so good.
Howie's a pro.
Now, Howie, what I want you to do is just fan out the deck to yourself and pick out any card you want. Don't show me, but remember it. Make sure everyone can see it. Great. Howie, if there's an invisible Sharpie right next to your cup, sign the back of the card for me, just with your first name.
Okay.
Great, I don't want to see it. And now, take the card, slide it right back in, put that all back in the box, and then throw it right back up to me whenever you're ready. Perfect. Now, you, just minor miracles, it's fine. Howie, you shuffled the deck.
Yes.
You picked a card, you all saw it for the very first time. What's the card that you picked?
10 of clubs.
I want to clarify something. You and I have never met, correct?
Never.
Nobody came up to you before the show, said
no.
anything?
No.
For the very first time, I'm going to open this up. You said the 10 of clubs, correct?
I did.
Because every single card in here is face up, except for one.
Uh-oh.
One card with a signature on it. Howie, can you confirm, is that your signature?
It is.
Will you flip that over for me?
Are you kidding me?
Is that your card? Thank you very much.
That's crazy.
Thank you. Thank you.
And he kept all his clothes on.
Heidi, what do you think?
I mean, the audience was so quiet. I haven't heard this audience this quiet all day. I mean, we were all like, like hanging by every word that was coming out of your mouth, and it was incredible.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
Really cool.
I'm like mesmerized. It was like fantastic, and it was funny at the beginning also with the invisible part.
Yeah. Thank
Good
you
job.
So much. Thank you.
I'm going to make a prediction. No more advertising jobs for you. Because this is what I think you were born to do. Genuinely.
Thank you.
Yes!
Thank you so much.
I gotta say, and you know, people at home are always skeptical because they think, I swear to you, nobody here was in on this. This is my signature. That was incredible. I loved it, you know? I think it was really good, and I think you're really good.
I'm gonna start the voting with a yes.
It's a yes for me too.
Sophia?
Yes!
And Simon, 4 yeses!
Thank you. Thank you guys so much. Thank you. Thank you, Cheryl. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Magic Mike! Oh my God! This is, how are you feeling? Tell me.
I feel amazing. I feel like I've had so much stress all day and now I feel like so pumped.
That is crazy.
That's my signature too.
Is it your signature?
It is my signature.
That's crazy, Tom.
It is crazy. I know, I want to keep this.
Hello.
Hi, Fritzy. Fritzy's only 15 years old. Fritzy, tell everybody about yourself, like where you're from and what you've done.
My name is Fritzy. I'm from Indonesia, and I'm a top five in Indonesia's Got Talent.
I realized that I have special abilities when I was 7 years old. I discovered that I could influence people around me, and I can hack into their minds. I made it all the way into the top five of Indonesia's Got Talent.
You got 4 years.
Thank you.
Fritzy, how are you?
People love magic, and I think this is exactly what my dream team needed. The reason you're here is America chose you. You have over 40 million people all over the world that clicked on you on social media. Who is that?
I will tell you in this stage.
So you don't want to, you want to surprise me?
Yeah, I want to surprise you.
Okay, so can I help you in any way? Do you need anything from me?
Yes, I need your advice.
My advice is involve the judges. Just be yourself.
For this performance, I'm going to hack into the judges' minds. I'm going to use my skills to win.
This is my friend. He's been my magical sidekick since I was 7. We're best friends. Say hi to everyone. I guess he's a little shy. May I join with you?
Yes.
Howie?
Yes?
Do you believe that my friend can tell you his name?
Yes.
Okay, now close your eyes.
Okay.
Try to focus and connect with my friend. My friend will tell you his name. You got a name?
I did.
Okay, now open your eyes. Write the name and then turn the pad over.
Okay.
Don't show to anyone.
And what?
Show it to everyone and turn it back over.
Show it to everyone?
You're the mentor.
No, don't show to anyone.
Oh, don't show to anyone.
Yes.
Did you mentor this act or not?
It's over. It's turned over.
Thanks, Howie. Everyone, let's give Howie a hand. Heidi?
Yes?
Do you believe that my friend can read your mind?
Maybe, yeah.
Okay, let's try that.
Okay.
Can you think one color?
Mm-hmm.
Are you done?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, let's say it together in a count of three.
Okay.
1, 2, 3.
Red!
Red? You choose red?
Yes.
Oh dear, my friend is a bit jet-lagged. Okay, thank you.
Thank you.
No, Melby? Can you please check my blindfold? Make sure it's legit.
Yes.
Okay, thank you. And Simon, can you hold onto this doll?
Yes.
Thanks. Okay, Simon, in a second, you will throw the doll into the audience.
Anywhere?
I'm covering my eyes to connect with my friend. Simon, please throw it.
They have it.
Hello.
Hi.
What was that? Okay. Are you wearing a navy t-shirt?
Yeah.
Are you wearing glasses?
Yeah.
Hold on.
Nah, that's wild.
Thank you. Oh. Howie, you wrote down my friend's name earlier.
Yes, I did.
Now, for the first time, can you show us the name you wrote down?
Yes. I wrote down my name backwards.
So...
Iwa.
Iwa?
Iwa.
Iwa?
Okay, Iwa. I just got my friend a name necklace yesterday.
Yes.
So, the name is...
That says Iwa.
And Heidi, look, it's your color.
I know, it's red.
Bumble.
Love it.
My name is Fritzy. Thank you very much.
Love it.
Wow, look, it's red and it says Iwa.
Come here.
It's
Why did red. You have to pick such a complicated name?
That was fantastic. You're only 15
Thank
years
you.
Old. It's your first time in America. That was magical. What did you think, Heidi?
I liked it. I mean, I was confused at times, but we got there.
I mean, you as a person, you're so adorable and you're so cute, but I think this act was a little bit small for this stage. And I think what you can take from that is think even bigger and better.
That's good. All That's right. good advice.
Simon?
I think because we've seen so much amazing magic over the years, this didn't have that wow moment.
What?
I think you got the wrong mentor, if I'm being honest with you, Fritzy. I think, look,
what?
This is,
harsh
I get
words,
it, you're 15.
Harsh words.
It still works.
It did?
Yeah.
But there's only five acts that are going to go through to the next round, so good luck.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Thank
wrong
you.
Mentor? Wrong mentor?
Yeah.
Wrong mentor?
Terrible mentor. You, as the mentor, shouldn't have been the person, because it looked like you rigged it.
Set up, yeah.
I didn't
it
rig it.
It felt like a setup.
I would agree. And she's only 15. You're how old, Howie?
Stop.
When I was traveling in India, I witnessed a ritual that happens by the river at night. The locals crowd on the riverbanks, and they fill bowls with offerings of candles, flowers, rice, and they float these bowls into the water whilst they make a wish. One bowl, reflected in the water, in the river, becomes two bowls. Don't worry, that is not the trick. But why double an empty bowl? And these bowls really are empty, totally empty. And so I will fill one of the bowls with a single grain of rice. One grain of rice reflected in the water and in the river becomes two grains of rice. That's one.
How do we see that?
Oh, that's two. The smallest piece of magic ever presented on this stage. But why double just one single grain of rice when you could double an entire bowl full of rice? I will fill this bowl with enough rice to fill it to the brim. No more and no less, just one bowl of rice. One bowl reflected in the water. And even though this is now a sealed chamber and my sleeves are completely up, I can't get in or out, there is now twice as much rice in the bowl as when we started. I will level all of this rice off. There is still rice in the bowl, that's important. On the riverbank, I see a man reflected back at me holding two brass bowls. And at that moment, I'm not sure if I'm real or if I'm the reflection, because the man in the reflection parted his bowls to reveal he is holding the bowls of rice, which means I am holding bowls of water. Thank you.
Oh, wow.
Is that it?
Thanks, everyone.
Don't tell me that was it.
That was it.
All right. Howie, what did you think? Are you confused? We all didn't know really when it was over, yes?
Yeah, just like...
I probably should have said, my name's Ben Hart, thank you.
Listen, this is Champions. Maybe it's your nerves, but it just kind of fell off at the end. Remember, only four acts are going through tonight. Is this worthy of being one of those? I personally don't think so.
Alicia.
I've seen Ben perform before, and normally your presentation is perfection. But what let you down tonight was the awkwardness of possibly what could be nerves.
This is Champions. It's gotta be perfect.
Simon.
It was like watching one of those weird info commercials.
you know, this is the rice maker, and I swear to, I mean, I'm struggling here as to know what to say, because I'm looking going, that's it? Ben, look, for someone of your talent and your charisma to come on this stage with that, I'm sorry, it was nowhere near good enough.
Oh, sorry. I feel terrible. I don't want to put more salt into the wound. Thank you so much for being here, Ben.
Thank you.
Oh my gosh, I feel terrible.
It was not good. But what I'm saying is, when he is good, he's great. So I've seen him be great. Such a shame.
Well, I think that, you know, there's different styles of magic, and magic's not always about, you know, like pyrotechnics going off at the ends.
Yeah.
And sometimes you want a story that lingers with people.
Hi.
Hello. Hi.
Well.
Breathe.
She seems a little nervous.
Okay. Sorry. I'm back, and I've actually been learning how to use my magic to try and get free things. Okay. You know, since I didn't win the $1 million. Mel, you know all about how to get drinks for free, huh?
Whoa.
Yeah.
Ooh. Oh, excuse me. Sorry. You need a drink as well.
Yeah.
I got you. Think of your favorite.
Whoa.
Cheers.
Is this?
Is it?
This is my favorite tequila.
Oh my God. And I have an espresso because I keep the energy.
Terry.
Yes.
Can I see your credit card, please?
My card? I feel like I'm at home.
Okay, thank you. Okay. Terry's credit card. We're gonna put it in the wallet, and I want you to put your hand on top to keep it safe. Yes.
Okay.
Now, Mel, I'm going to show you what got me here.
Go on.
Go ahead and say stop.
Stop.
Lock the card in your brain, and I'm gonna show everybody at home. Got it? Cool. Take the cards. I don't want to touch them.
Yeah.
This card represents you very well, actually.
Yeah, it does.
It does? You're a Gemini?
Yeah.
Okay, so you're born in May?
Yeah.
The fifth month, so it's a 5?
Yeah.
And you like diamonds? Because who doesn't? So it's the 5 of diamonds?
Yes!
Oh, that's good.
Go ahead and take the card out of the middle. Take the 5 of diamonds.
Where is it?
Take a look.
It's not even, it's not here.
You spread them out on the table, are you sure?
It's not there.
It's gone?
It's not there.
Well, the only cards I care about are playing cards, and I always carry one with me at all times in my wallet.
No, it's
Terry,
not.
I have my hand here.
No.
Raise your hand up off the wallet. Right.
No way.
Shut up. I'm diamond.
That is amazing. That is amazing. That's my card.
If Mel B's 5 of diamonds is in the wallet, then Terry, your card is missing.
Yeah, where?
Where is your card?
Oh, I'm gonna need that.
Thank you so much.
I like you.
What is the first thing they tell you to do when you lose your credit card?
Call them.
Yes, you call the bank and you tell them to freeze the card, right? So I've already gone ahead and frozen your card for you. No, okay. Literally, your card is frozen in ice in front of you all this entire
time. Stop it!
No!
No! No, it's there.
Oh.
It's there.
What?
Are you joking?
Wait, there's only one way to find out, and I brought my special magic wand with me. Terry, can you really confirm that that is your credit card?
I'm going to confirm this right now. Yes! That is my credit card! Got my name on it.
America, cheers, drinks are on Terry. Thank you all so much for having me back.
Thank you, Anna, that was incredible, incredible.
Mel, you were right there. What do you think?
Oh my God, you are brilliant.
and the tequila's got me a little bit, but you are great.
I did that on purpose, because the more you drink, the better the magic will get.
Simon, what did you think?
Well, look, she's that good that she nearly won the entire series.
Yes.
And you did it in your own unique, cool way. We have some incredible magic tonight, but I really genuinely hope that the audience get behind you and put you through to the next round, because you deserve it.
Thank you.
Welcome to our Las Vegas party suite. If I look around, it looks like we had a crazy night last night.
Yeah, because we celebrated a very special day, May 31st, 2016.
The date of our very first audition on America's Got Talent. And thinking about it, it just feels like it was yesterday.
Speaking of yesterday, I have no memory of what happened at last night's party. Do you, judges?
No.
Okay. Amelie will try to reach into your minds to find out what we did last night.
I have to put on this blindfold because that helps me get focused.
Simon, there are a bunch of different VIP cards and lanyards from Vegas attractions. We want to keep things random, so just take one of the strings, anyone you like.
Okay.
Yes, take it. Don't say what it is, just look what you've selected.
Oh, God.
Cover it with your hands. Concentrate on it and send your thoughts to Amelie.
Yes, I remember now, Simon. You insisted on going to this very special show, and that one was called Vegas Dark Divas.
Vegas Dark Divas.
It is Vegas Dark Divas.
Wow. Great.
And now, B, I kind of have the feeling we had something to eat last night. At least, that would explain all these menus on the table, like here, burgers, Thai, steakhouse.
Yeah.
Just make it random. Just point to any menu, anyone, whatever you like. Check it out. Yeah. Select one of the food options on there. Howie, come a little bit closer.
Okay.
Show Howie and myself, just with your finger, what you have selected. This?
Okay.
Don't say it. Amelie?
Okay, Melby, I think you went kind of for a breakfast. I guess something like fruits. You went for the raspberry yogurt parfait.
Yes, raspberry yogurt parfait.
It is.
I saw that.
Yeah.
Howie, what? You see all these room keys on the table.
Okay.
Confirm, all room numbers are different, right?
It seems that way, yes.
21, 29. Let's take some, put them inside here. I will look away, reach inside, and just take one room key. Not
okay.
Two. You
I've
have
got,
one.
I've got one.
Hold it against your body.
Howie.
What?
A pretty clear picture comes into my mind. Because yesterday night, we were walking around the casino, and you were wearing a bathrobe.
I was?
Oh, there's Howie's bathrobe. And Heidi, can you do me a favor? Can you read out loud what it says inside?
Do not remove from room 120.
Howie, for the first time, what room have you picked?
No.
120.
It is room 120! Here, you get your rope back. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
But wait a second. All the random selections you made are associated to numbers. Mel B, let us know what is the name of the restaurant you picked.
Cafe 53.
Howie's room is 120. And Simon, can I have a look?
You may.
You're sitting in row 1, seat 6. Because Heidi, I remember you did heavy gambling last night and you won. Can you remember?
No.
You
no.
can't, but oh. Heidi, I do have the proof because you won $53,120 in 16 cents.
Like Mel B's cafe, Howie's room, and Simon's row and seat.
Oh, got all the numbers.
I'm so sorry, Heidi. We already spent all that money
what?
On this. Everybody, stand up. Try and catch a bill.
Because on the bills, you will see the faces of the judges. Mel B's holding her menu from Cafe 53.
Howie has his room number 120.
Oh, show ticket, row 1, seat 6.
How is that possible?
That's insane.
There is a reason this all happened.
It all started on one day, May 31st, 2016. You remember the day of our audition?
Yes.
Everyone, have a close look or on this check.
May 31st, 2016. Thank you so much.
Thank you, America. Thank you, judges.
Thank you.
Hello.
Hi.
How are you? What's your name?
My name is Maxence.
Hi, Maxence. That's French. Maxence.
Yes, I'm French from Paris.
Oh, wow. And how old are you?
32 years old.
And what do you do?
Magic.
Oh, magic.
Yay, we love magic.
How long have you been doing magic?
I'm starting when I was 10 years old. I saw a magician in cabaret make amazing trick with my hands. My brain is boom, and I say, I would like to be a magician, and I'm here.
This is the dream, right? To be here in America, to do well, and maybe win this thing, and then...
magic is my life.
Aww.
Well, go ahead, show us the magic.
Of course. Okay, today, America, I will show you three things. One prediction, one appearance, and a final impossible. But to begin, I need your credit card, please, Ari.
Credit card?
Sophia, could you sign this envelope for me? Do you have a marker?
Yeah.
It's okay. I have one. Oh! I have another one.
Okay, that's
big good. Sign on it, please.
A sign of what?
What you want.
A heart?
Yes, of course.
It's beautiful, huh?
Beautiful. Now it's unique envelope, yes?
Yes.
And your credit, please.
My credit card?
Yes.
Well,
thank you. I put it inside the envelope. It's okay for you?
Yes, it's okay for me.
And I close it. Oh, stupid. Simon, could you grab it with two fingers like that? Did you feel it inside? The card, of course.
Oui.
Thank you. Don't worry. In case of trouble with your credit card, I propose to you a compensation. A just-in-case box.
Oh.
But please, don't open it unless I ask you.
Okay, just in case.
Let's start. Deck of cards, yes? This deck is a little bit special. We have 50 to drink on it, like, for example, coffee, red wine, beer, lemonade, tea. Of course, all the cards are different, blah, 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 okay? Mm-hmm. Touch any one card, but don't watch it for this moment.
Touch it,
anyone. Perfect, take it.
Thank you.
My friend, let me introduce my mini theater. Behind the curtain, on the mini stage, I made a prediction. Suspense. Ladies and gentlemen, my prediction is a can of cola. I did for the first time. Tell me exactly what is your card.
It's not cola.
It's what?
It's milk.
Damn it. You know what? Let me show you the thing. No, it's better. Let me show you the thing. I have some paper. Number it from 1 to 7. Behind each number, we have something. You will choose any number between 1 and 7, and you'll try to make appear the object which is behind your selection. Tell me one number.
3.
Are you sure you can do change if you want?
No.
If you told me another number, we have different object, yes?
Yeah.
Yes.
Yes.
But you tell me number 3, and it's a mini helicopter.
Okay.
I try to make appear. I can do it. I hope so. By the way, ladies.
Yes.
This is for you.
Thank you.
Music maestro! You always have the card inside, yes?
Always had the card.
Let me introduce the magic machine. Listen to me. At 3, we would put the envelope inside the magic machine.
No.
And the credit card will be disappear.
No.
It's amazing trick. You can... What? Suspect 2, 3.
No, that's
yes,
real. It's real.
Give me five, Simon.
contrary, do you remember in case of trouble we have the just-in-case box?
Oh, yeah.
Open the box, watch inside and show to everyone because...
Okay, you pull it down.
Yes, of course. Okay. Inside we have...
Scissors.
I never said it will be your card. Sizer is here for one reason. Since the beginning of the act, we have can of cola completely sealed, yes?
Yes.
Could you open the can for me, please?
Yes. Be careful with your nail.
You don't believe me, but inside it's not cola.
It's don't even.
Milk exactly like your choice. My prediction is true. But listen, listen. Take it and shake, shake.
What?
You hear inside? We have something inside. We need to cut the can because it's sealed. Fizzle, please.
I like the way you say that.
Yes, I do very slowly for you. Dramaturgy. Oh my God. Inside, we have something I don't want
watch
to touch anything, but watch. Inside the can.
That's your card?
Could you cross it? Yes.
It's got milk.
Exactly color. Your credit card.
That's my card.
That is impossible. Thank you, America.
Sophia.
I thought the whole thing was brilliant. You're so funny. The magic was also fantastic. I love how you interacted with us. I really love this act.
Okay, Heidi.
It was so much fun listening to you. I mean, you tick all the boxes. Funny, charming, you can do all the magic. Tick, 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 tick. I love what you just did.
Thank you.
Yeah, you're not only a great magician, you are very funny and you have this great energy. We didn't know where it was going, so it made it more surprising and fun. And can I have a cloth to wipe off my car?
Just use your pants.
No. Simon, what did you think?
At times, annoying.
No.
Unusual.
What?
Oh, yeah. However, the audience loved you. And the magic was très bien.
So let's vote. We're going to vote. I'll start with Sophia.
Yes.
Heidi.
Yes.
Simon.
Wow. I think all things considered, yes.
What is it?
I love it. Thank you.
We need a helicopter.
Thank you. That
here.
Was great. Thanks, America! Woo-hoo-hoo!
My daughter do this for me when she was just 7 years old. I keep it close to remind me of family. I had an idea. What if I could make her drawing to come life. Thank you. the real magic is family. Thank you.